Eco-renovating our standards of living. One community weekly progress update number 156.
One community is a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We are creating open source and free shared blueprints and resources, tools and tutorials, and do-it-yourself instructions for highest good living. Creating solution models that create additional solution creating models in the service of all life on this planet. This includes highest good approaches to food, energy, housing, education, for-profit and non-profit business creation, society, and true earth stewardship. We are creating all these things to be implementable as either individual components or as complete teacher demonstration villages and hubs. Welcome to the One Community Weekly Progress Update.
My name is Jay Sable, and I'm the Executive Director of the One Community 501c3 nonprofit organization. This is our Weekly Progress Update number 156, March 20th, 2016 edition. As always, I'm going to be covering 1 week of our team's progress and accomplishments with pictures and video. And if you'd like to see more details, more specifics, links to all the open source content, you can visit our written blog. Also, if you'd like to receive an email every time one of these updates comes out, you can send an email to onecommunityupdates@gmail.com and we'll add you to our newsletter list, or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. Let's jump into the updates.
One Community's approach to highest good education is open source and free shared, designed for all age groups, adaptable to any schooling environment, inspiring and fun for all participants, a learner-teacher collaborative, and it includes U.S. Common Core standards. This week, the core team, which includes the pioneer members plus those helping who don't wish to be individually acknowledged, transferred the third 25% of the written content for the cooperation and collaboration lesson plan to the website, as you can see here. This lesson plan purposed to teach all subjects to all learning levels in any learning environment using the central theme of cooperation and collaboration is now 75% complete on our website. Behind the scenes, we wrote the final 25% of the written part of the cooperation and collaboration lesson plan, bringing it to 100% complete. We also completed the third 25% of the mind map for the work lesson plan, bringing it to 75% complete, which you see here. One Community's approach to highest good food is duplicable almost anywhere, scalable for different needs, more biodiverse and nutritious, part of forwarding a global open source botanical garden collaborative, and includes 9 different free shared and duplicable growing environments. This week, the core team working on highest good food continued updating and further developing the work of Ana Flavia Almeida, architecture and urban planning student, into these renders for the transitory kitchen. This week's additions were more accurate textures, lighting, and backgrounds. This open source kitchen is purposed to feed 50 people in remote locations during sustainable village construction. We also added a new resource section to the Aquapini Wallapini page as seen here, and additional resources to the open source Hoop Houses pages too. The One Community approach to highest good housing is eco-artistic home building that is affordable, sustainable, do-it-yourself duplicable, resource and space efficient, and consists of 7 different sustainably constructed village models. This last week, the core team put another 10 hours into the behind-the-scenes revision for the footers, foundations, and flooring page for the crowdfunding campaign we are developing. This week's focus was setting up a chart for the mixed ratios of the earth bag contents of Section 9 and revising the vertical wall insulation back to its original horizontal location in Section 11. We'd say we are now 73% complete with this total update and rewrite behind the scenes. Working on the Treehouse Village Pod 7, Jessica Rohrbach, architectural drafter, designer, and 3D modeler, created all the designs you see here for the Treehouse Village game room structure and also added some final details to the kitchen structure. Dean Scholes, architectural designer, further developed what's necessary for us to create quality Cobb Village Pod 3 renders. Here is update 11 of this work that continued with Cobb sitting space design details. Brianna Johnson, interior designer, also continued evolving the renders for the Strawbale Village Pod 2. What you see here is the third render of the central recreation space now with enhanced colors, fire added to the central fire pit, and other aesthetic enhancements.
One Community is also creating an open-source duplicable city center.
It is designed to be LEED Platinum certified, provide 12 guest rooms, dining for over 150 people, and laundry and recreation space for over 300 people, all while saving money, time, space, and resources. This week, the core team continued working on the renders for the DUPLICABLE City Center. What you see here is a work in progress, continuing with textures for our dining dome render and adjusting the lights in the kitchen dining area. Bhupesh Sithala, interior designer, working with input from Rob Jurdy, swimming pool design and construction expert, began working on the design for the natural pool and spa mechanical room details. Here you see Bhupesh's research and initial design plans. Iris Sue, industrial designer, put the final touches on the pipe, couch, and table chair designs for the DUPLICABLE City Center library by creating these final measurement documents for the couch and then detailed assembly instructions for both the couch and table chair, including a final render, parts list, and step-by-step instructions for putting them both together. Fantastic work by Iris Sue. Brianna Johnson, interior designer, also continued her work on the pipe shelving for the library. What you see here are the results from more lighting research and the addition of the lights we liked most as part of Design Layout 2 by Brianna. Behind the scenes, Mike Hogan, automation systems developer and business systems consultant, and Lucas Tsui Da Silva, fourth-year computer engineering student, continued development of the control system's main panel. What you see here is a circuit diagram proceeding forward with last week's designs and a collection of pictures with Mike showing how these circuits will connect different components. The One Community approach to highest good society is globally focused, individually enriching, cooperative and collaborative, includes a highest good network and application, four different economic models, and combines fulfilled living and true earth stewardship for the benefit of all people and all life on this planet. This last week, the core team created final versions and added the open source trademark infringement letters to the legal documents and processes page. These letters were written with the help of Oz Chersky, lawyer specializing in trademark and copyright law. We also made final edits and then updated our primary highest good hub icons throughout most of our website. The foundation of the icons you see here were designed by graphic designer Ivan Monzarov.
One Community thinks it's time for eco-renovating our standards of living. What we mean by that is we believe that it's time to build a better way of living based on an evolution of sustainability that combines the physical foundations of sustainability, which are food, energy, and housing, with the emotional foundations of sustainability that we've identified as highest good education, highest good economics, fulfilled living practices, and true earth stewardship. Putting these things together in a way that creates a way of life, a standard of living that most people will feel is better than the way that they're living right now, and they will want to adopt it. And so this is what One Community is creating. We're open sourcing and free sharing all the tools, tutorials, resources, and do-it-yourself instructions for what we describe as highest good living. It's a way of living that is good for people, good for planet, good for the economy, good for all living creatures, and it's built on sustainable infrastructure, which is one component of it. We're doing this as teacher demonstration communities, villages, cities, and hubs to be developed around the world as solution models specifically designed to develop additional solution-creating models. Our idea being that if we eco-renovate our standards of living and teach others how to eco-renovate their standards of living, that we can improve the standard of living for everybody on our planet. We're doing this in this comprehensive way that combines the food, the energy, the housing, with the education, the economics, the fulfilled living practices, the stewardship, because we see all of humanity's challenges that we're facing right now as not only interrelated, but interdependent. So we think that a comprehensive solution that addresses all aspects of life is necessary. And this is why eco-renovating our standard of living is actually possible, is because we can look at all aspects of the way that people live right now, and by building on an ecological, on a sustainable foundation, we can create a way of living that is truly for the highest good of all. And so we're bringing together the people with a consciousness for the highest good of all, that believe this is possible, that believe that the time is now to create this, that believe that we can transform our world within our lifetime to one that is sustainable, that meets the needs of all people by making it easy enough, affordable enough, and demonstrating as attractive enough. We're bringing together people that believe that that's possible, and we're doing it. We're creating that right now. And we're creating blueprints for complete sustainable village models. 7 different sustainable village models, a replicable city center, but everything that we're doing is designed so it can be implemented as either individual components or as a complete self-sufficient, self-replicating model. This is what one community is doing. If this sounds interesting to you, if this sounds fun to you, if this sounds like something that you like to be involved in, there's lots of different ways to participate. The easiest way, of course, is by sharing our information on social media. We're on all the different social media networks to make it as easy as possible. We're on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Reddit, Tumblr, Pinterest, and about 15 others. Or you can get involved as a partner, as a consultant. You can get involved as a pioneer, the people that will move to one community and build everything that we are designing right now, and will operate the first prototype, the first teacher demonstration community designed to invite tens of thousands of people and eventually hundreds of thousands of people to come and experience what one community is all about. And if you like what you see, if you like what you experience, to take that information out and replicate it with the open source blueprints, tools, tutorials, and resources. This is what one community is up to. This is what we're doing. Of course, people ask, well, you know, what is the largest thing that could help one community right now? We're still seeking large-scale funding. The primary thing that we're focusing in on is all the blueprints, the tools, the tutorials, the resources, the open source content that is what our nonprofit is all about. We're all volunteers. We're all unpaid volunteers, including myself. Every single person that's working for one community is doing it because we want to create a better world, because we want to live this way, because we think it's possible, because we want to participate in something world-changing, because we could believe the idea of eco-renovating our standards of living is possible. But we're still seeking large-scale funding. And so if you know somebody or are somebody with resources to possibly help us with that, we would love to speak with you. Changing the way that every single person lives on this planet, creating a model that could create a better way of life, is possible if enough people want it, if enough people participate. It's really just a matter of participation. We talk about how we're building a bridge between pragmatism and idealism. We've got this pragmatic path built on the foundations of things that have already been done around the world, and we're just putting it together in an open source and free shared manner that can build a world that truly works for everybody. We can improve the standard of living for everyone if we start working on collaborating and cooperating instead of competing, if we work together to create the open source tools, tutorials, resources, and blueprints that are possible. And this is what one community is doing. This is what we've been doing for 5 years. And so we will keep on keeping on, as I say every week. Thank you for following our progress. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sharing our information. Thank you for the emails that we get. Thank you for all the support. This is what we're doing. If you'd like to get involved, there's lots of different ways to do that. And we will continue. Until next week, have a great week. Thanks for following our progress. Thank you.